Amos 9 and 11, and verse 12 for that matter, when it's talking about the tabernacle of David, it's referring to what's taking place now. This goes hand in hand with Ezekiel 37 chapter, one of my favorite chapters. And Ezekiel 37 chapter should be read a lot more to get the understanding and to make Israelites understand what this awakening is. This, what's happening right now, is a great awakening that started back before the turn of the century, 1800s, but the spark that made this thing really come to light was when Abba came on the scene, and then you have the elders that came after, and then you have ourselves, which are the new elders and the new apostles that came after them. Anyway, this is a kind of a response to a video that Apostle Gabar put up, entitled, by the way, giving all praise to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai Bashem Rakakodash, if I didn't say it. This video is entitled, What Apostle James Really Said in the Correct Understanding of Amos 9, verse 11 to 12. What, I'm not going to really talk about what James said, but the fulfillment of Amos 9, verse 11 and 12 is referring to the kingdom, the coming kingdom, when the kingdom is established. Because the kingdom will be established based upon the house of David. The house of David are all the tribes that were back there with King David during that generation. Yeshaya, high priest Yeshaya, used to say, well, the house of David is Judah. No, he was wrong. That's why he's out. That's why he's not in the truth. That's why he's back in the world. The house of David represents all the tribes that was with David during his lifetime. And they're back in a thing called reincarnation, something that goes completely over Vocab Malone's head. But anyway, when it speaks about possessing Edom and all the heathen, round about, I'm merely paraphrasing, it's talking about the lands. The answer to that is in the book of Obadiah, which is one chapter long. When you read the 18th verse down to the end, it speaks about the other lands that we're going to take. Now, one of the main lands that we're going to take and possess is the land of Edom. So that word Edom is not talking about the Edomites, although we're going to possess the Edomites. But in Amos 9, 11 to 12, when it says possess Edom, it's talking about the land of Edom. Like I said, go back to Obadiah, the next page over, and you can start from the 18th verse, and it's going to tell you that the tribes are going to come together. It mentions Jacob, which represents Judah, and the rest of Israel, and Joseph, which is Ephraim, which represents the head of the other tribes of the kingdom of the northern kingdom, that they're going to come together in the kingdom. Obadiah 1 verse 18 will take place in the kingdom of heaven after this devil is worked in the field and got his ass whipped and beat down and slaughtered and just kicked around. After they are destroyed, we will take their land. And we're going to take their land while they're there, because they're going to be scattered among the Israelites to be slaves. The slaves didn't have in America, didn't have a land that they went to, the slave land. At the end of the day, they went to the slave land or the slave cities. No, they slept in the goddamn, them damn shacks that Esau built for slaves, which are called slave quarters. You lived where you were enslaved. You worked out in the field, you worked in the house, then you had house niggas that lived a little better than field niggas. But the field niggas lived in shacks. They lived in slave quarters. So they can get up early, bright and early in the morning before the sun come up and go out there in the field again. So in our kingdom, Esau will be scattered among the Israelites to be slaves. You know, 12 years a slave is going to be 1,000. Well, they should make a movie called 1,000 Years a Slave. And after that 1,000-year period, Esau is going to be gathered together, because we're going to get tired of looking at that devil. And he's going to be gathered together, and he's going to be burnt up. And Vocab, I hope like hell you're an Edomite, man. I truly hope that you're an Edomite. So you can taste this. Yeah, future, the future kingdom. So let me say this again. When it says Edom, it's talking about the land of Edom and all the heathens, all the lands. If look, all you got to do is go to Blue Letter and look up the word Edom. One of the definitions of the word Edom is the land of Edom. Then you got this one guy, Yo Classics or whatever his name is, he just doesn't understand the scriptures. And in closing, I'm going to say this. We shouldn't be going back and forth with these people that don't get it. If there's somebody that comes on the comment board or the live streams on the comment board and they ask a legitimate question, maybe you can save a soul. But when you got a guy where you know the man don't, he just don't got it, you got to start cutting these people off, man. You know, I'm like I said, you know, we ain't, hey, the new thing is we ain't fucking with the two-thirds no more. Anyway, with that, I'm going to say shalom. On to the next one. And curses and destruction on Edomites and other nations in this current world. Dawada, shalom.